Hello my dear friends, welcome back to a new video of I Square. So in today's class we are going to begin a new chapter from your textbook, that is matrices. So let's consider a situation like this. So this is the situation. Radha has 15 notebooks and 6 pens. Fauzia has 10 notebooks and 2 pens. And Simran has 13 notebooks and 5 pens. So the situation is that it discusses about 3 persons and the number of notebooks and pens they have. So let's put this situation into a tabular form, which means in a table form. So here I am going to assign the names of the person, that is Radha, Fauzia and Simran. And like this I am going to put the number of notebooks and the number of pens. So Radha has how many notebooks? Radha has 15 notebooks. And similarly, Radha has how many pens? She has 6 pens. Okay, again Fauzia has 10 notebooks and 2 pens, while Simran has 13 notebooks and 5 pens. So this is a tabular representation of this particular situation. So let me give another tabular representation of the same situation. It would be like, here we have the number of notebooks and here we have the number of pens, and like this we have the persons, that is Radha, Fauzia and Simran. So Radha has 15 notebooks and 6 pens. So 15 notebooks and 6 pens. Again Fauzia has 10 notebooks. Yes, 10 notebooks and 2 pens. While Simran has 13 notebooks and 5 pens. So this is another tabular representation of the same data. So now I am going to put this in a rectangular box like this. Only the numbers in a rectangular box like this. And this box contains 3 rows. Which are the rows? This is the first row, this is the second row and this is the third row. And how many columns this rectangular representation have? This is the first column and this is the second column. So a representation of a situation in a rectangular array in columns and rows is called a matrix. So this particular thing is an example for a matrix. So we can rewrite it like this. We always represent matrices in square brackets and we will put the elements in the square brackets like this. 15, 6, it is the first row and I can call it as R1. And the second row contains 2 elements, 10 and 2, let it be R2. And the third row contains 2 elements, 13 and 5. So there are 3 rows and how many columns? There are 2 columns, let it be C1 and C2. So this rectangular representation is called a matrix. So this one is another form of this matrix because it also conveys the same data. So this is another matrix like this. 15, 10, 13, 6, 2, 5. So this is a different matrix from this matrix, but both the matrices represent the same situation. So this is the definition of a matrix. A matrix is an ordered rectangular array of numbers or functions. So let's put an example here. It is a rectangular array of functions or numbers. So I am writing the matrix as 2, sine x, cos x, again 3. So this is an example of a matrix because this is a rectangular array and it contains numbers and functions. So let me give you another example. This is also an example of a matrix. So this is also an example of a matrix. It is a rectangular array of numbers. So that's it. We have seen 2 examples of a matrix, and this particular matrix has two rows, that is this one and this one, and two columns, so this one and this one. So the number of columns is 2, and we read this as by, and the number of columns is again 2, and we call this matrix A as 2 by 2 matrix. This is a 2 by 2 matrix, and this 2 by 2, that is the number of rows by number of columns, is called the order of the matrix. So in that case, in this example, the order is 2 by 2. Coming on to this example, it has 3 rows. So 3 by, what is the number of columns? 1, 2, 3. So the number of columns is again 3. So it is a 3 by 3 matrix. So I have a question for you. Can you write an example of a 2 by 3 matrix? What matrix? A 2 by 3 matrix. So a 2 by 3 matrix should contain 2 rows. How many rows? 2 rows and 3 columns. So I'm going to write 2 rows like this, that is 2, 3, 4, and this is the first row, and I'm going to write the second row like 4, 7, 8. So 2 rows are here. Now I have to check whether it has 3 columns. This is the first column, second column, and third column. So this is an example for a 2 by 3 matrix which has two rows and 3 columns. So always remember that the number of rows by number of columns is called the order of a matrix. In general, we can say that we use capital letters to denote matrices. For example, this is matrix A, this is matrix B. Let this matrix be matrix C. So any matrix A can be represented like this, and its order can be represented as M by N in general. So this is the general form of a matrix, matrix A of order M by N, which means A is a matrix with number of rows M and number of columns N. Now we are going to represent the general form of a matrix. Let it be A. Let A be the matrix of order M by N, which means the matrix A should have M rows and N columns. So A can be written like this. It is a rectangular matrix with M rows, that is 1, 2, 3, etc. Let there be some I, and the number of rows should be M. So this is the number of rows, and the number of columns is N, which means 1, 2, 3, let it go like this, and somewhere let it be J, and the number of columns is N. So let these be the arbitrary form of the matrix A with order M by N. So the first element can be called A 1, 1. Again, the second element is A 1, 2. Always we will write the row number first and the column number second. And again it is A 1, 3. And again it is A 1, J. And it goes like this. And we have A 1, N. Now, the second row will go like this. A 2, 1. Again A 2, 2. Again A 2, 3. And we go like this, and we have A 2 J, and again we have A 2 N. Going like this, we have here A 3 1, A 3 2, A 3 3, and A 3 J, and etc. We have A 3 N. Now we will put etc. here, and in the ith row we have A I 1, A I 2, A I 3, and etc. We have A I J, and we have A I N. So this is the ith row, and it will go like this, and we have the mth row like this. A M 1, A M 2, A M 3,
Again, it will go like this, and we have A, M, M, J, and we have A, M, N. So, this is the general form of the matrix A of order M by N. So, the elements of a matrix is represented using small letters with the suffix with the number of rows and number of columns. So, this is the general form of a matrix.
So now here is an example for a matrix. Consider the quadrilateral ABCD with the vertices A10, B32, C13 and D12. Represent this in matrix form. So a quadrilateral with the vertices A, B, C and D are given, and the corresponding coordinates are also given, that is x and y coordinates are given. So the x coordinate of A is 1, where the y coordinate of A is 0. Similarly, we have 3, 2 for B, 1, 3 for C and 1, 2 for D. So the rectangular representation of these numbers, which contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 rows and 2 columns, is an example for a 4 by 2 matrix with 4 columns and 2 columns. So this is a matrix representation for this particular data. Or another way, we can represent it like this. We can choose the coordinates as rows and the vertices as the columns. So we have the xy coordinates for A like this, 1, 0. For B we have 3, 2. For C we have 1, 3. And for D we have 1, 2. Again, this rectangular representation is also the representation of this particular situation. So this matrix also denotes the particular situation here. And what is the order of this matrix? It has 2 rows, okay, and 4 columns. So it is a 2 by 4 matrix. So this particular matrix and this particular matrix both are the representations of this situation. Now we are moving to another question, and the question is, consider the following information regarding the number of men and women workers in 3 factories 1, 2 and 3. So this is the data given, and we are asked to represent this as a 3 by 2 matrix. Not that, represent it as a 3 by 2 matrix. The order of the matrix is given, which means it should contain 3 rows and 2 columns. So first of all, we want 3 rows, and look into this data. It already have 3 rows and 2 columns. So this particular data, from this particular data, this rectangular form is an example of 3 by 2 matrix, and this 3 by 2 matrix represents the given situation. Now, what is the entry in third row and second column represents? Third row, this is the third row and this is the second column, and the entry corresponding to third column and third row and second column is 26. It will represent the number of men or women workers. Since it is second column, it is the number of women workers in which factory, 1, 2 or 3. Since it is third row, we have the number of women workers in third factory. So the entry in the third row and second column represents the number of women workers in third factory. The next question is, if a matrix has 8 elements, what are the possible orders it can have? So the number of elements in a matrix is given, and it is given that the number of elements is 8. So what are the possible orders it can have? So we are asked to find the possible orders of matrix in which that particular matrices have 8 elements in total. For that, always remember this concept, that is, if a matrix is of order M by N, which means it has M rows and N columns, then the total number of elements in the matrix is always MN, that is M times N. So
Always remember that for a matrix of order m by n, the total number of elements is mn.
Here, the total number of elements is given as 8, which means mn is given as 8. Mn is given as 8. Now, we want to find the possible values of m and n, that is the possible ordered pairs m and n, such that the product mn is 8. So, go to the factors of 8 and we can find that 1 times 8, that is 1 into 8 is 8. So, a matrix of order 1 by 8 will have 8 elements. Again, 8 into 1 is also 8. So, another matrix of order 8 by 1 also has 8 elements. Again, we have 2 into 4 as 8. So, a matrix of order 2 by 4 will contain 8 elements. Again, we have 4 into 2 equals 8. So, a matrix of order 4 by 2 will also contain 8 elements. So, the possible orders of the matrix is like this: 1 by 8, 8 by 1, 2 by 4 and 4 by 2. All these matrices will have a total number of 8 elements. So, this is the end of this question. Now, we shall move to another concept. Now, we have a question like this. Construct a 3 by 2 matrix whose elements are given by Aij is equal to 1 by 2 into mod I minus 3j. We are asked to construct a 3 by 2 matrix. So, we are going to construct a matrix A whose order is 3 by 2, which means it contains 3 rows and 2 columns. So, the general form of a 3 by 2 matrix will look like this. It is A11, A12, again A21, A22, A31 and A32. So, there are 3 rows and 2 columns. So, this is the general form of a 3 by 2 matrix. So, now we want to find A11, A12, A21, A22, A31 and A32, and hence we can find the 3 by 2 matrix required. So, the condition for Aij is given like this: 1 by 2 times mod I minus 3j. So, A11 can be written like this. Here, I is 1 and j is also 1. So, it is 1 by 2 into mod I minus 3j, which means 1 minus 3 into 1 is again 3, which means 1 by 2 into 1 minus 3 is minus 2, mod minus 2 is again 2. So, it is 1. Now, we have A12. A12 is simply 1 by 2 times mod I minus 3j. I is 1. Okay, 1 minus 3j, that is 3 times 2, which means 1 by 2 into 1 minus 3 times 2. 1 minus 3 into 2 is 6, which means it is minus 5. And we will get it as 5 by 2. Now, we want A21, which means 1 by 2 times I minus 3j, which means 2 minus 3 times 1. So, it is 1 by 2 times 2 minus 3 is minus 1. So, mod minus 1 is 1. So, it is again 1 by 2. Now, we want A22. A22 means 1 by 2 times mod A22, which means 2 minus 3 into 2, which means 1 by 2 into 3 into 2 is 6. So, 2 minus 6 is minus 2 minus 6 is minus 4 and the modulus becomes 4. So, it is simply 2. Now, we have A31, which is 1 by 2 times I minus 3j, which means 3 minus 3 into 1. So, 1 by 2 times 3 minus 3 is 0, which is 0. So, now at last we want A32. A32 can be found out like this: 1 by 2 times I minus 3j, which means 3 minus 3 into 2, which means 1 by 2 times 3 minus 6, which means it is minus 6, minus 3. Mod minus 3 is 3, so we have 3 by 2. So, now we have found all the elements. So, now we are going to substitute it here. So, we have 1, again 5 by 2. Next, we have 1 by 2. 2, again 0 and
3 by 2. So this is the required 3 by 2 matrix which we were asked to construct.
So in today's class we have learned the basic concepts of the chapter matrix, and the next class we will deal more with matrix. Till then, wait for the next video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.